How's it going, everybody? It's your boy Mike from Seattle, and I have been investing with one of Dave Ramsey's endorsed local providers for the last 7 years. So what I want to do in this video today is break down my experience using one of Dave Ramsey's recommended ELPs, endorsed local providers, and share my experiences with you so that hopefully you can make a more informed decision as to whether or not you want to use one of his ELPs. Now, Dave Ramsey has ELPs for lots of different things, to help you get out of debt, to help you buy a house, and also to help you save for retirement and come up with a retirement investing strategy. And that's the ELP that I used. So back in late December of 2013, I went on the Dave Ramsey website after listening to the show for years and listening to their YouTube show. I went on their website and I signed up for the Endorsed Local Provider program to have somebody that he calls a smart investor come meet with me and lay out a good financial plan for me to save for retirement.
So that's why we put together the Smart Vestor program.
So what we're going to cover today are my actual returns. I'm going to pull up my actual statements with my account balances. We're going to look at the amount of money that I contributed, what it was put into, what type of mutual fund specifically, what my rate of return was year over year, what my expense ratios were, everything that you might want to know moving forward. Now, obviously, it sounds like he uses a bunch of different local providers depending on where you are in the country. And in order to be one of Dave's ELPs, you have to essentially teach the same principles that he does and live by the same standards that he does.
And then generally, who wants to buy an endorsement from Dave Ramsey? Well, people that kind of believe like Dave Ramsey, hello, you know, and so if they think I'm an idiot, then why would they buy an endorsement and be one of our Smart Vestor pros?
So I guess you can't necessarily say that everyone is created equal. One may be better than the other, but this is at least a rough idea of what you can expect an ELP to bring and provide to you based off of what Dave Ramsey teaches. So first, let's talk a little bit about his ELP program. So as I go to his website, it says right here, what is a Smart Vestor? A Smart Vestor is a free service that connects you with our network of financial advisors, wealth advisors, financial planners, and other investing professionals. These are the people we trust to take care of you and your investors. How does a Smart Vestor work? Step one, complete the form and see up to 5 different Smart Vestor pros in your area. Number two, your Smart Vestor pros will contact you within 24 hours. And number three, interview your pros and choose who you like best. So they've changed it slightly since I went through the program 7 years ago and got someone. For me, it was fill the info out, and they just sent me the contact information for one individual. That was who I met with. I liked the guy, genuinely think he was a good person. I think he's done a tremendous job for me. We could talk about that in a little bit when we look at returns. But ultimately, the individual that I met with, who I'll choose to leave anonymous, I felt like he did espouse Dave Ramsey's principles to get out of the debt and have an emergency fund saved up before you consider investing in retirement. So at least my initial meeting with the individual, it seemed like he was really trying to make sure that I'd followed all the Dave Ramsey protocols before he and I actually started to talk. All right, folks, now you have to bear with me here because I'm going to try to make sure that none of my private information or account numbers get exposed here for, you know, the 5 people who watch me on YouTube to go and do what they will with it. But, you know, maybe if I blow up for whatever reason, I don't want some hacker to come and steal all my money. So we can see right here that my annualized since initial investment, and my initial investment was August 1st of 2014, and since then I have averaged a 12.78% return year over year, which again, as Dave Ramsey talks about, 8 to 12% for mutual funds. I'm actually outperforming this on a 7-year time frame. So I feel like I'm doing a pretty good job, but of course you want to keep perspective in mind. I started after the last major financial recession. I did take part in this coronavirus recession, but because I continued to invest through it, I've seen gains since then. I really have not had a major nasty long-term bear market run to affect my average. But as it stands right now, the last 7 years, if you had invested in the same stuff as me, you would have averaged a 12.78% return on your money. Year to date for 2021, I'm up 7.69%. And you can see down here, American Funds is the name of the actual company that I am investing with. They're a relatively popular investment company like Fidelity. And I'm part of their growth portfolio. You can look this up on Google, though I don't believe anyone can purchase it unless you are actually an approved like vendor through them. Like I can't go on Robinhood and find this stock ticker and purchase it myself. I actually have to go through someone who's affiliated with them to buy it, as far as I'm aware. I may be incorrect about that, but I'm pretty sure that's how it works. Okay, so let's take a look. My current value on this is $24,000. That's what I am at right now. Okay, so let's talk about what an expense ratio is, because this is what it ultimately is costing you to invest in your mutual fund. An expense ratio, or an ER, also sometimes known as the management expense ratio, measures how much of a fund's assets are used for administrative and other operating expenses. An expense ratio is determined by dividing a fund's operating expenses by the average dollar value of its assets under management. Operating expenses reduce the fund's assets, thereby reducing the return to investors, right? So this is the money that they skim off the top to pay themselves to operate the fund. Of course, they've got to make profit, but what is a good expense ratio? What's a bad expense ratio? So again, back to Google, let's go ahead and take a look at this. What is a good expense ratio? A good expense ratio from the investor, me, the investor's viewpoint, is around 0.5% to 0.75% for an actively managed portfolio. An expense ratio greater than 1.5% is considered high. And the other thing to keep in mind here is that these expense ratios are always going to be higher than an index fund or an ETF. I'm going to do a video comparing index funds and ETFs later, so just look for that in the future. But because this is an actively managed fund, those managers are getting paid, and that's where my expense ratio comes in. So back to my actual retirement account, you can see right here that I'm at a point that is 0.73%. So I'm right in that margin that I want to be at, between 0.5% and 0.75 for a efficiently priced expense ratio. All right, so when I had loaded that last web page and left it up, it was from yesterday, and just from yesterday to today, the market did something, and I'm actually up at 25,000 now. So I guess some of those numbers have already changed just in the little bit of time I've been putting this together. So again, you can see right down here, I am buying Class A shares of the American Funds Growth Portfolio, GWPAX. I have a total of 989 shares valued at $25.31 a share. The current value of my Roth IRA is $25,043.26. Okay, so let's take a look at actually how I've performed over time. So you can see right here the portfolio value history. The beginning portfolio balance, as I mentioned earlier, was $270. Additions that I have made, contributions that I have made, I have contributed a total of $14,920 over the last 7 years. Now, that's way beneath the maxing out my Roth IRA on a yearly basis. Again, for years there, I could only afford $50 a month and then $250 a month and now $500 a month. I've never maxed out my Roth IRA in a single year. But the $14,920 that I contributed is valued at today $25,043. So it's $10,000 of straight growth is what I've made. And if you come down here and look at my portfolio value history chart, you can watch the growth as it starts. The growth goes up year over year. Interesting thing here, the only year where I actually went down in value was between 2017 and 2018. My account dropped from 9,892 to 9,737. And I remember when I saw that, I didn't stress, I didn't panic, because as someone who at least takes it upon myself to research the market, I understand how it works. You have good years, you have bad years. But I kept purchasing at the same rate that I always have. And as you can see, if I had panicked and left, if I had just decided to dip out, fire my guy, go somewhere else, recede out of the market, I would have missed the huge growth that I then experienced from 2018 to 19, 19 to 20, and 20 into 21. You can just look at the numbers right there. There's the value of the account, is that number that I'm highlighting. And then the net investment, that is, I believe, the amount of money that I'm contributing on a yearly basis. Net investment is the total amount invested minus the total amount withdrawn. Yeah, I'm not withdrawing any money. So how much money am I putting in each year? And you can see as that's going up. But you can see the exponential growth as my portfolio's value, because of returns, starts to pull away from the actual amount of money that I invest. Okay, so what I pulled up for you here are the last 90 days worth of transactions for my portfolio. You can see that the last 2 months are the only 2 months where I've actually contributed the full $500, and really it's $525, where I've contributed $500 into my Roth IRA. And you can see that they immediately deduct $25, $28, and what that pencils out to is about a 5.6% of whatever I contribute gets taken off the top. I assume it's the fee for the guy who's actually managing what I have, who's actually managing my portfolio here. Because the fund managers have the expense ratio, and then my guy charges me a fee whenever I contribute. And I understand there's people out there who will naysay and say, well, index funds and ETFs, they don't have these fees, you don't get nickel to dime like this, your returns over time are significantly better. If you actually took the $25, you know, over the next 40 years and calculate that for every time you contribute, that's going to equal $1 million yourself. You are 100% right. Agree with you. No qualms. Here's the thing. I know myself. I know the time that I have. I don't have time to research ETFs and to research index funds. I just don't have the time for it. I don't. I'm not the kind of person who's dumb enough to think that I can do enough research in just an hour or just a little bit of Googling. If that's what you want to do, I'm not saying index funds are bad or wrong. They're clearly they outperform mutual funds 97% of the time and at a cheaper cost. Index funds are fantastic. That being said, the number one reason that people struggle to have enough money in retirement is because they never even get started in the first place. So I don't care if I'm paying someone and losing out on some of my potential gains right now. I know it's not the most efficient, but as I just showed you, I'm averaging almost a 13% return year over year over the last 7 years. And what I do have the time to study and what I do have the time to research is the real estate where the overwhelming majority of my net worth is actually tied up in, and where almost all of my passive income comes from. You know, that $4,000 mark that I talked about earlier, needing to generate $4,000 a month in order to retire comfortably, I'm going to be able to blow those numbers out of the water within the next 2 to 3 years here as a 33-year-old guy because I invest in rentals in the Midwest and I live frugally beneath my means. So this entire retirement account that I have right here, the whole thing, this is my last resort, last ditch effort. If everything else fails, at least I still have this. But this is by no stretch of the imagination plan A. And I'm perfectly fine with letting somebody else manage it for me, even if I'm paying a fee. Now, again, in the interest of being transparent, I'm trying to show you as much as I can. I pay 5.6% of whatever I contribute immediately off the top to the advisor. And then I have a 0.73% expense ratio on the fund itself. But I'm still averaging 12.76% return on my initial investment. I've only ever contributed $14,000, yet I have a $25,000 value in the account. And I know there's probably some of you out there who are talking about, well, that's not very much money in a Roth IRA. That's not that impressive. For 7 years, you should be way better than that. Hey, man. I grew up extremely poor. I've lived in a very impoverished lifestyle, and I didn't want to be poor. And I knew I needed to start with something. And before I even heard of Bo Hansen and Brian Preston, the money guy, I knew that at least if I could just get, you know, as they always said, just save a cup of coffee a day, you know, and I don't even drink coffee. So there you go. Just putting a little bit away, and it has paid off. All right, guys, hopefully I answered all your questions. I think I did a pretty good job here of showing how beneficial this has been and impactful it's been in my life. I 100%, if I could go back in time to my younger self, I would give myself the advice of, yes, sign up with this guy, put as much money as you can in each month. $50 is great. As soon as you can afford 75, do it. Don't wait till you can jump to 250. Once you can go from 50 to 75, send him an email. Once you can go from 75 to 100, send him an email. Once you go from 100 to 200, send him an email, because I would be even further along than I am now. The biggest problem that people have in terms of saving for retirement is that they fail to start. They fail to launch. You have to start somewhere. I know that it seems like pennies in a swimming pool, and it is. And you look at it and you say, I'm never going to get from here to there. But you will if you just do it consistently over time with enough dedication. That's how you become successful at anything in life. So get started, whether it's with this guy or with somebody else. I have seen success here. I would recommend Dave Ramsey's ELPs to other people, even though I disagree with Dave Ramsey on certain things now as I've gotten older and moved away to a hybrid between his baby steps and other financial advice I've taken. I definitely think that the getting started as young as possible and using an expert in your area to teach you a little bit, just enough to be dangerous, getting started is the most paramount thing you can do. So, guys, appreciate you watching. Consider leaving a comment or like or subscribe down below. It does take me time to put these videos together. And hey, we'll catch you next time.